started the program, I didn't want to be there. I was uncomfortable, very shy. I didn't know anybody. And like, I expected everybody there to judge me and stuff like that. But it actually opened my eyes to the way I look at people. I don't expect people to go through the things that they do. And it kind of affects the way that you treat people. And in the group, basically, we connected with each other through our strengths. Like, I like write poetry, so they allow me to read my poems and uplift my poems and stuff in the group.
I was pretty much like the same way. Like, I didn't want to be there. I was like, I will say, I was never involved in anything that had to do with school up until this group. Like, this group actually made me want to like do more stuff like in the school and like help out in the school and everything. So it was like, it was a good experience. Like, it helped like build a lot of relationships. And like India said, like, it's like crazy to see what so many different people go through. And these are things that like people at young ages go through, because we were dealing with students. We didn't even get to like deal with adults. So it's just like seeing someone that's like the same age as you going through like stuff like that, it's like, it's life changing. And we all just built like really good relationships with everyone. And it just, it helps you like as a person, like in life, like you see stuff from a different perspective, and like it helps you like deal with some different situations. Like, we did, what's the activity that we did where it was like, we talked about, like, how to deal with, like, conflict and, like, stuff like that? It was something creative, something creativism or something like that. It was, like, the day before we dealt with the teachers. Activities like dealing with like people getting out of their comfort zones, and it was a really good experience. And yeah, I liked it.
It made you want to reach out to people.
Yeah. Like, by the end of like the last day, it was pretty much just like, it was sad. Like, it really was. It was sad because it's like, this is coming to an end. Like, most of us probably won't even like talk to each other anymore. Like, everybody wanted to make a group chat. Like, we're still gonna like keep in touch, but now it's just like, half of us are graduating, and like some people from last year already did graduate. So it's like, yes, it was.
And it kind of put a responsibility on us as to how do we want to keep this going? How do we want to keep affecting like communities and reaching out to people and making people realize the stuff that we realized?
What did you find out about yourself? What did you discover about yourself that you didn't know before?
One thing I did learn about myself is I am a very good facilitator. Huh? Like, I would say a leader, yeah.
Okay.
Like, it definitely helped me like put myself out there more. Because before, I like never used to even like talk to anybody, like look at anybody. Like, I'd be that person that's just like off on their own. Like, I'm still that person, but like now I feel like I've gotten better at like making relationships with people. And I've gained like a lot of understanding and social skills that will definitely help me. And I really wish that they would have done this in like one of like the elementary school camps that we did, or in middle school. Because I definitely think it could help, like, especially growing up, like people like going through things, and like help you like gain understanding and just like broaden your perspective.
I feel like, I agree. I feel like if they started it at a young age, like, it would help so many kids. Like, cause this is like, they're telling us this before we actually go into the real world. But it's like, if they tell you this while you're young, this is basically just like, you won't even have to deal with stuff that people that we've already encountered and dealt with. Like, you'll know how to react to different situations and stuff like that. So I feel like they should start it at a young age.
You know, you guys are so expressive.
Yes.
No. Did it build as much self-confidence?
Yeah, actually.
Really? Over what period of time? I mean, was it just the fact that you interacted with your peers, or Did you look at things differently?
I think it's kind of because they like forced us to like get to know each other and like feel comfortable around each other. Because I know a lot of people just like sat there and like didn't do anything the first couple of days. And then we kind of established like a safe zone with our community agreements. And once everybody was like comfortable with each other and like everyone knew like nobody's gonna get judged, like it's okay. We realized we all go through a lot of the same things, even the teachers.
Uh-huh.
When we had the teachers and students, we did an activity where we made a big circle and then somebody would say something. And if you like, I could say like I have brothers and like whoever has a brother would just like step in, or it could be something even deeper. Like, I mean, we had one person.
We had like a lot of comfort zone stuff.
You know, this is really amazing. Like, you guys saw some commonality, the common ground, right? And that's what made it very comfortable to communicate with each other.
Yeah. It definitely like helped understand that like, everybody's like not who you think they are, and they're like not as judgmental as you think they are, because you're kind of like worried about like, oh, like what are these people gonna think of me? But it should be more as like, what do I think about myself, and like how
I feel like that's what like, it was dealing
like
with
self-reflection. Myself. Yeah.
Right.
And growing up, like you kind of get this mentality that you know not everybody's there to help you. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Even like
yeah,
your parents
that,
teach
like,
you
I'm
that.
On my own thing.
Yeah.
But it's like dealing with that group is like, we were pretty much like there for each other, like through a lot of stuff. Like people would share stuff in their poems, and then like afterwards, everybody would like go talk to that person. Like we'd exchange numbers with people. Like it's really good relationship, friendship building.
The portrait, was it individualized, or did you guys collaborate? It's so expressive. You did?
Like our poetry,
mm-hmm.
or just in general?
Just in general.
They started us off with in my one beat, and then it's like they just gave us that one verse, and then you just create an entire poem just from starting that one verse in my one beat. So that's like one of the things that we did, and then they had us free write poetry and bring it in and talk about it. And
now this is amazing because I mean you were writing in iambic pentameter, weren't you? I mean that structure, and you were able to express yourself through that meter. That's amazing.
That's another thing that we did, like. Every student there, we expressed ourselves through music and poetry.
Yeah, some kids could sing.
Yeah, a lot of kids could sing, a lot of kids played instruments. Actually, one of the things that we did when the teachers came in, we all, like, all the students, like, got together, and we, like, sat and we sang a song, because that's what we normally do, like, throughout our normal day. Like, around lunchtime, like, someone will grab the guitar and then, like, well, I'll just, like, start singing a song everybody knows. And we just all,
yeah.
Pretty much like came together.
Were there any songs that you wrote?
No.
They're
just
songs in general?
Just any songs, yeah. They could be like from now, they could be like 4 years ago, but somebody would just start playing the guitar and then we'd all just.
Would you have done that before?
No,
not
yet. It's like, it's weird to say because I really like music and I know, I wouldn't say every song, but I know just about every song. I still wouldn't have even done that.
So you think this RITH program has really broken down a lot of barriers for you?
I think it breaks down a lot of barriers for people.
And on top of connecting with students, like, we connected with the teachers a lot. Like, there's this one teacher I connected with so well, like, he wanted me to, like, you know, send him some of my poetry and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
It was amazing, like, because you don't think teachers, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Really,
you don't really care.
Yeah.
It was
just
so many,
see me for
that's one thing, like, it was so many students freaking out because teachers were gone, and, like, us, because we're all, like, close with all of our teachers that are, like, at Starkweather, and we had really good relationships with them, so we were just like, okay, teachers are coming, like,
yeah,
what's the big deal, and, like, they were freaking out, and I'm just like,
that's amazing,
this,
yeah.
Yeah.
It's
like,
amazing, because,
and like, I understand, like, but there's still that barrier, and I'm like, no, they're people just like us. They're just adults.
So you developed a level of trust, and you were able to communicate with your teachers a lot better. Yeah. Did you fully trust them, and they had that confidence in you?
Yeah.
That's good.
I have an additional question. I know that Benjamin talked a lot about being equity stewards and stewardship instead of leadership, because leaders imply power, that you hold power over someone else. And so can you talk a little bit about what you learned about being an equity steward and how you might be one? what kinds of things you've done even so far.
What do you mean?
Yeah.
honestly, I don't really know because I never really used the word steward. Mm-hmm. Like, it was kind of just a term. Yeah.
But yet you do some things, though. You've had an impact, I bet, right? Maybe we can have you share what have you done even here at Starkweather that you think has taken what you've learned and made an impact in another place or with other kids.
Are you talking about what we did at the assembly?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, so we had this assembly with all of our students, and Mr. Wayne, he wanted me to facilitate because I facilitated the activity with the teachers, and I mean, it's like, I feel like I have more respect for teachers and adults than I did before, because actually, like, being a facilitator and seeing, like, what they deal with, it's kind of like, really? Like, why? So I don't know, I would say that. So it's like, if I'm like in a classroom, like we have a substitute teacher or something like that, and it's like students are just being disrespectful just to be disrespectful, like I'm usually the one to stand up and say something about it.
You know, the word facilitator is sort of synonymous with leadership, you know?
Yeah.
You're assuming that role, right? What made you feel as though that you could step out and become that great facilitator? Was it encouragement from your peers, or was it something?
Yeah, I feel like it was encouragement, because everybody's like, oh, you can do it, go ahead. I feel like it's because normally I'm quiet, but it's like, if I have...
DJ?
Yeah. I'm very soft-spoken. I usually keep to myself, but it's like, when it comes time for me to, like, you know, like, step up and, like, take that role, I'm usually the one that's, like, the loudest out of everybody, and people listen to me, so it's...
Okay.
It's good. Mm.
Okay, one of the other things that I think is unique to this work that we spent a lot of days together with Benji and Wade and the group, and it was very unique because we spent a lot of time making safe space, and we used the arts, and we talked just before you came back from the tour saying that some people may say that, like, why are you doing all that? Like, what's with all the music and what's with, you know, what? You know, why are we spending so much time creating a safe space? And I think it might be important for people to hear why that was important to you.
Mm-hmm.
So can you share that, like the value of that, and because it, and maybe then also share where we can go from here with this work? Because I'd love to hear from you as recommended, as students who participated in it. Where should we go, guys?
Without that safe space, we wouldn't have been able to build the connection that we built. Like, a lot of us learned stories and struggles that each of us went through. And it opened your eyes to how you look at people. And, like, after we built that connection, it became more of kind of like a family thing. Like, mm-hmm. I can't wait till Benji and Wade comes back. I can't wait to go do this. Even if you weren't trying to, like, it affected your life outside of that program. Like, you come to school and you look at people different, you want to help more, you want to do all types of stuff. And with the program, though, like, we were all just talking about it, like, how it went so, like, so terrible. Like, maybe because we didn't create that safe space. If we would have had that safe space, then people would have felt more comfortable instead of trying to be cool, you know what I'm saying? And, stick with their friends and stuff, they would have been comfortable to going around and talking to other people and stuff. So that safe space is really important.
What would you love to see us do as a district now that we did this, we participated in this? What should we be thinking about as we...
We're graduating, so we're trying to keep the program continuing, but I think it would be important for, like, to have, like, some type of program to continue. You know what I'm saying?
I think you should continue the program, but I was talking to Tracy about it. I think you guys should randomly select like students, just like how you did us. Because before this, we didn't talk, we didn't really know each other like that. So I think randomly selecting students is a good idea, and it's kind of like a, it's like a, who wouldn't want to, you know, get out of school and go hang out with people and listen to music and like learn new stuff and do activities. Like, that's fun.
Can you talk about the ideas when we met about 2 or 3 weeks ago, and you guys set some goals of what you wanted to accomplish this year here at Starkweather? Can you remember what those things were?
they weren't any of my ideas.
I know we wanted to create like a student-led mission statement for our school.
Mm-hmm.
So kind of just like what the students think like should represent us instead of just like our name. Because a lot of people have heard bad things about this school that are true. And it kind of just would help our reputation and really bring up this school and show people like it's really not just like an alternative school for bad kids who do bad things and like all that.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like what people don't understand about Starkweather is, yeah, it's an alternative school, but it's no different than any other high school. You go to school, you get your work done. It's whatever work you put in, and that's just in life. Whatever work you put in, that's what you're gonna get back. And that's how it is at Starkweather. If you don't come to school, if you don't do work, you're gonna get dropped. If you come in, you give your all, you're gonna pass. Like, that's pretty much how school is anyway. It's just alternative. Like, there really isn't a difference between us and the park.
Difference is size, and you actually get to build a relationship with your teachers.
And I feel like that scares people having to build relationships, because like one of them said, it's hard for people to communicate with other people and build relationships with other people because people are so like, oh, like I'm taking care of myself, like I'm myself right now. But it's like, kind of can't do that. Like, you have to build relationships and like work with your teachers and work with your peers, so that way you can go far.
And that's something else that should be put into, like, if we, like, you guys want to continue the program, is having teachers and adults, like different randomly selected adults, along with the students, so they can build relationships too.
Yeah, I think it's definitely important that teachers learn this stuff too. Just kind of, a lot of the teachers kind of just said like it opened their eyes, and they didn't really know that students felt this way, and they actually felt a lot more respected after we got the students and the teachers together and kind of did all of our activities. So
Mr. Lane spoke about a mission statement. One word, would you want to see in that mission statement with best sort of identify that whole program?
Definitely equality.
Quality.
Because we didn't have, like, there were, like, no gender roles, no, this is a teacher, this is a student. There weren't, like, any roles, really. It was kind of like we're all just here.
Yeah.
Like, everybody was on the same page. Like, we all worked together.
Respect for each other. Mm-hmm. You don't have people disrupting you.
Mm-hmm. And talking to your peers, do they share the same sentiment about the school in general?
Yeah. I think it's a good divide. A good amount of people agree,
it's like,
and some people just really do not care.
But it's like the people that don't care are affected because of their friends.
Because
it's like some of the students, like, we actually know, and it's like you see them with their friends, and you're just like, you're not like that.
Any other questions from the group? I just wanted to just share out loud that I was never so blown away by the students who participated in this group. And I know, Kevin, you were there a lot, and how you saw some of it, and to witness it was just changed the adults that were there. You may want to share. It changed our lives watching this. It was unbelievable. And if we ever want to change the world, this is the way to do it.
Absolutely.
I agree. 100%.